in my head, parang yung naisip ko, I that's the world that I want to be far from. I don't want anything to do with it. Because for me, I already feel like showbiz is dirty enough. Parang, this is my limit.
Eh, kaya lang, hindi iwasan mo yung mundo na yan. Pero ayan, nagka-boyfriend ka nang nandyan sa mundo niya.
Yes. And actually, sa ano sa pinakasimula nung sinasabi sa akin ni Sam na tatakbo siya for Congress. Congress pa lang ng time na yun. Ako talaga, no. No, I will not allow this. Magbe-break tayo. Yung kasi parang ganong level, naging malaking,
ano sagot niya?
Naging malaking problema siya. Well, hindi naman nag-last yung ano. Hindi ko naman natiis din. Kasi, nakita ko din eh. Nakita ko din kung ano, kung ano yung nakukuha niyang fulfillment from it, na I have to be real with myself, na that's a smile that I can never give him, yung ganong klaseng fulfillment from what he does when he helps people and makes changes to make people's lives better. I can never give him that kind of fulfillment, and I think na, you know, this is the, kung ano man yung mga dahilan kung ba't ayaw ko yung politika, wala yun kay Sam. I would not be okay with it unless I truly believe in my heart that his intentions are pure, that his heart is sincere, and he's serious about wanting to make positive changes. And I also believe that he's qualified and knows how to do it. Because he's always been a good leader. He's a good leader for his family, for his companies, all of them. And even if I hate being told what to do, I still trust him to lead me also.
Tapos yun, na-interview namin siya. Tinanong namin siya about wedding plans. Ayaw daw niya hanggat di tapos ang election kasi ayaw daw niyang gamitin niya or mapagbintangan siya na gagamitin yung kasal niya sa pagtakbo niya. Anong reaction mo?
Well, ano, I'm... Thank you, boo-boo. Thank you.
Ikaw ba ayaw mo pa din?
Ayaw ko.
Ayaw mo pa din ang kasal?
Ever since I was in my teens, parang yung naisip kong perfect age, yung dream age ko to get married was 35. And guess what? I'm 34. So, I mean, I'm not naman saying na, oh, game na, kailangan next year na. No, it's just for me, I feel like I'm not naman in a hurry. I really enjoy yung relationship na meron kami ngayon. Kung paano kami ngayon. Wala akong nararamdaman na may something kulang. Walang kailangan gawin. I just like, I've never been in a kind of relationship that's so mutually supportive, loyal, and wala, ganun. We move like a unit. So I'm very, very grateful for that. And I mean, if it happens, then great. And then if it doesn't happen, also it's okay. Kasi wala, I don't talaga feel like may nagkukulang sa life.
Pero do you know how special or how different? Not to compare this relationship with the other relationships. Ano yung special, ano yung great about this relationship?
I think we have a very special connection. I don't know, our energies are like magnets. Like, we're always looking for each other. We never stop talking to each other about everything. He knows everything about me. And I know everything about him. Wala. Kahit yung mga nakakahiyang things, wala talaga kaming tinatago sa isa't isa. And ayun na nga, yung we're a team eh. We move as one. We support each other completely. He's very supportive about all of the things that I care about, and I'm supportive of all of the things that he cares about, and I want him to have it all, and he wants me to have it all.
Ano yung nakita mo sa kanya na, you know, to make this work?
I think also parang we met each other at the perfect time. I think what makes it work is we're mature enough na. Kasi I think kung na-meet niya ako like 1 year earlier, or if I met him 1 year earlier, it would not be the same. I don't think makikita namin yung mga bagay na nagustuhan namin sa isa't isa. Kung, if we met any earlier, I think it's just at the right timing, divine timing.
Ano feedback ng family mo on
him? We actually, ano, we always laugh about it kasi may yung, what do you call this? Para bang yung personality ng family ko is very, very different from Sam's personality. So we always laugh about it. I go, grabe, no? Tapang ni Sam. There's no one talaga that can tell him like something cannot be done. Or me, I'm not like that. I'm super opposite. Ako yung parang, ako, I say, I'm being realistic. Siya yung nagsasabi sa akin, that's not realistic, that's negative. You're being negative. Na parang ako parang, ay, parang mahirap yan, huwag na lang kaya. Ay, parang, ano ah, hindi yata, parang ganun. More on ganun yung boses ko, sa utak ko. Yung boses niya sa utak niya is always, kaya lahat, let's go for it, ganyan. So, I think it's one of the really positive things na anong tawag dito, like he put it in my life, a positive lesson that I've learned from him, and my family sees that. They see that I've become a much more driven, much more positive, much more divinely believing person. Yun.
Yeah, in general, ano yung mga takes sa wedding or sa marriage? Kasi pag-usap ng business, in general, not necessarily with some na power. In general, ano yung ganang mahalaga sa iyo kasama?
Sobrang hindi siya priority for me ever. Like, hindi ako lumaki na meron akong dream wedding. Ay, hindi ko alam kung ano yung shape ng dress na trip ko.
Mga details.
Oh, super wala. And also, I feel like it's a tricky thing to sign up for, especially in this country where we're only one of the two countries in the world, or two places in the world, without divorce. And people get trapped into very bad situations. Ayun. I mean, as much as we want marriage to be a very romantic, very cute, very, you know, very demure kind of thing, the truth is, it's a very, very big responsibility and commitment that you cannot take lightly, and you can't be 18 and in love and then realize, oh my gosh, I wasn't ready. Because annulment, kailangan yung magsiraan or something to get it. No, I'm serious.
Yeah, it's yeah. Very messy.
Uh-oh, imagine we're only one of... There are a lot of things where the Philippines is really not very progressive. It doesn't make life easy. Diba? So yun. So, I mean, I can wait.
So yun nga, tatanong ko, ibig sabihin, halimbawa for magtutuloy-tuloy yung relationship nyo for like 2, 3, 4, 10 years na hindi pa rin kayo kasal, okay lang sa'yo?
Okay lang.
Pag niyaya ka naman yung bigla next year, you will say yes?
Siguro.
Yes.
If I like the style of the proposals.
So, okay lang, halimbawa, you're forever, hindi man forever, for many, many years na hindi kayo kasal pero nasa relasyon kayo, okay lang sa'yo pala yun?
Okay lang. Kasi ano eh, you know what, marriage is, I mean, one, it's something that you do in front of God and your family and all your loved ones to declare, diba, your loyalty to this person forever. But my issue about it is the legal side.
What meaning?
It's, marriage is a contract that's drawn for you by the government. And you have to agree to all of these terms and
abide by the rules.
Oh, abide by the rules. And then I just don't feel like there's a lot of protection for women inside of the way marriage is done in this country.
You have a very good point, actually.
Thanks. Personally believe naman that I don't need any protection sana from Sam, diba? So if niyaya ako next year or something.
From
Ayo. No, hindi naman sa Ayo ko. It's just I don't need it to go anywhere. Walang kulang kasi. I just don't lack anything. It will be wonderful if it happens. And if he wants to ask me, then of course that would be every little girl's diba? Dream. But if not, it's okay also.